fellow Hatebit podcast host and good friend of mine, the Sainted Magnus. He went and he did a video recently talking about 15 games that define you as a gamer. I thought this was a pretty interesting topic to go and talk about, but I decided that I was going to put my own little twist on this. It's still a video response, but my twist is that it's going to be a thing of games that define my personality in general. So, the first one is going to be No More Heroes for Nintendo Wii, unless you picked up on PS3, then it's No More Heroes Paradise. Anyhow, so, Travis Touchdown, main character in No More Heroes. I have to say that if I could relate to many characters, literally, like in real life relate to them, it would be him. He's just a random video game nerd, anime fan, manga fan, and then decides, fuck it, I think I'm going to go out and become the world's best assassin. And he does that. Now, minus the whole go out into the world and become the world's best assassin part, yeah, I can actually feel like, you know, this dude's totally fucking relatable. I wish that I had an awesome little lightsaber like that to run around with, but it's not a lightsaber, but, you know, whatever. But still, really fucking badass game, and yeah, I relate to this quite a bit, just like me. And might just be like quite a few of you out there, too. Now, the next one, this is all because I like campy, cheesy horror movies, and all around just really like scary shit in general. Whether it's morbid or gory, doesn't really fucking matter. If you go and splash tons of blood onto something and just make it entertaining in some kind of way, I'll probably pay attention to it. And that's the original Resident Evil. Now, I could have used all the Resident Evils as a reference, but I'll go with the first one, because it was the first time I got to experience anything fucking even remotely like this. And it was awesome. Seriously, all you have to do is just listen to the dialogue, the way that's played out throughout the entire duration of the game, and you could literally be left in stitches. So this could even border on, like, comedy, horror, survival thingamajigs. Doesn't matter, I love it a whole bunch. It's got zombies, it's got mutated monsters, it's got the motherfucking tyrant, and Barry Burton. He has this! Yeah, I have to hold the game while I do that, so I can't put it up here. But anyway, it's Resident Evil. Fucking love it. And as far as my personality goes, yeah, I think this would be wedged somewhere in there. So, huzzah! Now, like Travis Touchdown of No More Heroes fame, this character right here is also somebody that I can relate to, despite the fact that I'm not some gigantic, hulking, fucking steroid and fueled as, well, badass. Duke Nukem Total Meltdown, but I actually want to go with Duke Nukem, you know, 3D on the PC, but I don't actually have a physical copy of that anymore, sadly. That's what happens when you lose shit over time, but anyway, Duke Nukem. Okay, Duke Nukem, he's going out trying to save the world, but the thing is, it's his personality, and that's one of the reasons why so many people were paying attention to it back in its heyday. Duke Nukem is all about hot chicks, blowing him, fucking them, strippers, titties, and all the other jazz. And he quotes a ton of shit from the Evil Dead series. That right there gets you an A+ for effort, and he's a relatively funny guy. So, beyond the fact that he's going and just splattering alien brains down the pavement and everything, and jumping in his fucking little jetpack and flying around and shooting fucking rockets at everything and blowing them up, well, quite frankly, he's pretty fucking awesome. That, and he has the mighty boot, just boot, boot. Boo, just fucking shit-stomp everything American History X style. So yeah, Duke Nukem, Total Meltdown, fucking right. Well, I like my personality. Now then, speaking of badasses like Duke Nukem, we have another badass of Devil May Cry fame. It's motherfucking Dante. Dante likes rock and roll, likes metal, he likes eating pizzas. He's sarcastic, witty, has a bunch of comebacks and quips and random things that he'll go and spout at anybody, no matter how fucking threatening, how towering that they are, just lumbering about ready to kick the shit out of him. He's just like, fuck you, and he just beats the living bejesus out of them, and it's fucking awesome in every single facet and form. This game was ahead of its time. As a matter of fact, all action games still look to this pretty much as a blueprint of what to do. And Dante was one of the main reasons why people became so attached to the series and still are to this day. He's an awesome-ass character. I mean, he's the son of motherfucking Sparta. And his brother is also just as bad as him. Because Dante, I mean, the dude dual-wields pistols and switches between them and a sword and uppercut shit, says a bunch of funny stuff, kills things. It's sorry, but that's fucking awesome. And quite frankly, if I had powers like him, yeah, I think that personality-wise, I could end up trying to emulate that as best as possible. Now this, people might be like, what the fuck were you smoking? And that's the point. Because I'm so fucking random off the wall, sometimes people are just like, he must be on drugs. No, in fact, I don't do any drugs whatsoever, despite the fact that some people are like, he must be high. No, but the thing is, quite frankly, because I'm all out there and everything, Katamari Forever! Well, Katamari Damacy, we love Katamari. I love all the Katamari games. You're just rolling up a fucking ball, that's it. But it's always entertaining as shit. And because this game is so random, so fucking just out there, I can relate to it quite a bit. And there's a lot of other games that I could go and put up there with this, but quite frankly, this was the first one that came to mind, so that's why I want to go and use this one. So you're the prince, you're rolling a ball and shit, and you have to go and collect stuff and make it really big. And I have to say, quite frankly, for any villain out there that ever want to go and take over the world, you just need a Katamari ball and like a couple minutes of time, and just go and roll up everything. You'll start with little shit and everything, you know, picking up like pennies and thumbtacks and everything. Soon enough, you're picking up people and you're picking up cars, then you're picking up skyscrapers, then chunks of land, and then the stars themselves. Quite frankly, that's fucking awesome. Then your dad is the king of the cosmos, and he's awesome, and he has a bitchin' wardrobe. It's like Liberace just fucking exploded with a bunch of Crayola colors, and just, there you go. But yeah, badass. Fucking love this series. So yeah, as random, as goofy as it is, of course I can relate to it. And last, certainly not least, Brutal Legend! Brutal Legend! It's the most metal game of all time! I even said that in one of my videos. It's the most metal fucking video game of all time, and for very good reason. I mean, you're Eddie Riggs. You get dropped into the world of metal. And I just love the fact that everything about it, they go through the entire history of metal, and they come up with, literally, their own folklore for metal. And that's really cool. The game's really funny, fun as fuck to play, quite frankly, needs more love, needs more attention. But the main thing is because of the music in it, because of the world it encompasses. I've been a fan of metal for such a fucking very, very, very long time. And this is just oozing out of every single polygonal pore, filled with awesome ass shit for any metal enthusiast or anybody that even just remotely likes it. Hell, even if you aren't really into metal, you could still pick up something like this and enjoy the living shit out of it. So quite frankly, I have to say that if I was going to talk about anything, and I thought about Guilty Gear too, and I thought about some other games with bitchin' soundtracks that are very metal. But Brutal Legend is the one that always comes to mind whenever I think of my musical preference. It's this, right here. So yes, Brutal Legend, I can definitely relate to. But those are all the games that I can relate to as far as like my personality goes. And there's a ton of others. I walked around my entire game room and I was looking through, and there are some others, but I just want to focus on those ones. I figured that'd be enough for the video and everything. Now, the thing is, what games define you as a gamer? Or if you want to talk about which ones define your personality. Like I said, the same that Magnus was talking about ones that define you as a gamer, I decided to just put a little twist on it. But regardless, if you want to go and make a video response, make it to the same that Magnus, unless you want to make the personality one, then I guess you can make that to me. Regardless though, oh, and if you haven't checked out Mr. Magnus's channel, then you should do so, because he's a bad motherfucker. Then he's on a hate the podcast with me, so fucking zah! Anyhow, I hope that you enjoyed me just bantering on about all those other fucking random games there that, quite frankly, I hold very near and dear, and I can even compare and reflect myself as far as personality goes. What are some of yours? Talk about it in the comments, video response, all the other good shit. So, anyhow, this, as always, is Alpha Omega Sin, nerds, nerdettes, and gamers. Game the fuck on. You know what, some other games that I can relate to near and dear? Catherine, because I fucking love crazy chicks. Quite frankly, it's kind of hard not to love crazy bitches. I mean, it's just, it's a good thing. And that's a very, very good thing. What else can I relate to over here? Like I said, the Guilty Gear games over here, Guilty Gear X, X2, Suka, XX Asset Core Plus. I can relate to those. Fucking metal. Soul Bad Guy. Oh, yeah. Those are fucking awesome. Know what else? Dragon Ball Z. One of the first animes I ever truly got attached to and just want to fucking hug to the point that I just compressed its spine and fucking snapped it in two because I loved it that much. You love it to death. But yes, Dragon Ball Z. Ooh, what else? Chaos Wars. This game has some of the worst motherfucking, like, if you've heard some of the worst dialogue and voice acting any game, and you have not heard Chaos Wars, I assure you 100% you'll want to check that out. It's funny as fuck. I swear that they were paid to sound like shit. If they weren't, I have no fucking clue. That just makes no sense to me at all. What other games can I relate to over here? Manhunt. Because I would love to go around and just fucking murk and murder people left and right. It seriously would make my day. I mean, when a game allows for one of your murder weapons to be a plastic bag, that's pretty cool. So yeah, Manhunt. I feel pretty cool about that. That'd be absolutely fine with me. Let's see, what else can Alpha Mega Sin relate to? This. Rumble Roses. Because I would love to be sitting in a gigantic throne of nothing but dead corpses while hot chicks go and beat the shit out of each other to win me as a prize or something. That'd be fucking awesome! Granted, that doesn't happen anywhere in the game or anything, but hell, I'll put my own spin on it. Naturally, an all-metal soundtrack and fatalities out the fucking ass! Every character will have like 1,000 of them, and you only want to see the Titty Twister one. Just pop one of those fuckers off like a fucking helicopter blade, just ow. Just whatever. Yeah. Shit happens. Shit happens! Those are random games that I can relate to on some level or another. So, that's it. I'm done babbling. Rabble, babble, 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 babble. I have fucking pizza rolls waiting for me, so I'm gonna end this video in 3, 2, 1. Just kidding, I'm not ending the video yet. I'm just gonna keep on fucking dancing, bitch, yeah. Maybe this is one of the reasons why people think that I'm on drugs. Nope, I assure you 100% everybody, this is all natural. I just literally get bored sometimes and will just... It's this fucking camera, so I'm just gonna dance by and do goofball shit. Most people would try to do something like this and be like, I don't know, I feel kind of embarrassed. I don't give two fucks at all. Not 3, not 10, not 50. I don't give a fuck what number you throw out there. You could be like, 100 million, billion, zillion? I'd be like, no! No fucks given! Zero! Zip! Zilch! Nada! Not a damn thing. But, seriously. Yep. About the fact that I have a Captain Planet figure here. The power... Oh wait, here we go. The power is yours! And it was always funny because at the end, the company that made it was Deke. And I saw it when I was little, and I was like, dick, 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 ah! Except for I couldn't let my mom hear me, or she'd come up, and she'd be like, Shoryuken! And I'd be like, no! I'd be like this, no! Poor Captain Planet. Oh, you want to know what else is funny? I found these at the flea market, by the way. Duke Nukem. I was just talking about Duke Nukem, and then, see, here, let's get this bad boy out. So we have Duke Nukem, and Duke Nukem. Duke Nukem, meet Duke Nukem. Ooh, yeah. It's just dirty. So anyhow, that's it. Now I'm officially done rambling. So, later!